Now we will study the new concept of power in AC circuit and power factor. Now in the previous classes we have studied that whenever an AC voltage V is equal to Vm into sin omega t is applied to an LCR circuit. If you take the LCR circuit, we are applying an AC source whose instantaneous value is given by V is equal to Vm into sin omega t, where Vm is the peak value that we know. Then we obtain the expression for current in an LCR circuit that is given by I is equal to Im into sin of omega t plus phi. Now this current and voltage, they are having a phase angle of phi. If it is a pure resistive, phi is 0. If it is pure inductive or capacitive, then phase angle is pi by 2. If the circuit contains all the three, inductor, resistor and the capacitor, then the current and voltage, they are having a phase value of phi. Now we have plus phi. We have assumed that the capacitive reactance is greater than the inductive reactance. Based on that one, we are having a plus phi. If capacitive reactance is less than the inductive reactance, then obviously we will get minus phi. Here it is the capacitive circuit, therefore current leads, therefore we are having plus. If we have XC less than XL, then this term becomes omega t minus phi, because the circuit becomes inductive, therefore voltage leads the current. Voltage mundirtane, current hindirtane, agage minus phi bartade heli. And we have obtained the expression for the current. Im is equal to, it is Vm divided by Z, where Z we called it as impedance, and is given by square root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square, that we have derived in the previous classes. Clear? Now this is the instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current. Now we have to work out what is the power dissipation in the circuit. The instantaneous power dissipation is given by the instantaneous voltage multiplied by the instantaneous current. Now instantaneous voltage is Vm sin omega t, and the instantaneous current is, it is Im sin omega t plus phi. Now is equal to Vm into Im sin omega t plus phi into sin omega t. Now this is the product of two sine functions. Now we use the identity, trigonometric identity, 2 sin A sin B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos of A plus B. We are using this identity, 2 into sin of A, sin A sin B is equal to cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. By using this identity, we can write this one as P is equal to Vm Im. Now here sin A sin B, but this 2 is there. If you cross multiply, you are getting 1 by 2. Cos of A minus B, omega t plus phi minus omega t. Therefore, it is cos of omega t plus phi minus omega t minus cos of A plus B. That is omega t plus phi plus omega t. Now, further simplify this one, we will get the instantaneous power Vm Im into half. This becomes plus omega t minus omega t cancels. Therefore, we are getting cos phi minus cos 2 omega t plus phi. Now this is the expression for instantaneous power. Now we have to work out average power dissipated over one complete cycle. Now average power in one cycle, that is bar P, we write bar P is equal to, now we are using this notation, Vm Im by 2 and average of cos phi minus cos 2 omega t plus phi. Now look here, Vm Im by 2, it is a constant, therefore Vm Im by 2 into cos phi into cos phi, it is also a constant because it is a time independent function. Cos phi is a time independent function, therefore it is a constant. Now we have to work out what is the average of cos 2 omega t plus phi. In the previous classes we know that average of cos function or the sine function, which is a time dependent function, its average over one complete cycle is 0. Why it is 0? For every value in the positive half cycle, there is a corresponding value in the negative half cycle. If you add them, you will get 0 that you have studied. So therefore, bar P is equal to Vm Im by root 2 cos phi minus, what is the average of this cos function? It is a time dependent, therefore it is 0. So therefore, we have the average power is equal to Vm Im by 2 into cos phi. This is the expression for average power dissipated in an LCR circuit. I will rearrange the terms. Therefore, bar P is equal to Vm. This 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. Therefore, I am writing Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2 into cos phi. Therefore, the average power is equal to, what is Vm by root 2? It is V RMS value. It is the RMS value of the voltage, and this one is RMS value of the current into cos phi. This is the final expression for the power dissipated in an LCR circuit. Now look here, in the case of AC, the power dissipation not only depends on the voltage, not only depends on the current, it also depends on a new factor, that is cos phi. It also depends on cosine of the phase angle. Cosine of the phase angle is called power factor. Therefore, cos phi is called as power factor. In the case of AC, the average power dissipation not only depends on the voltage, not only depends on the current, but also depends on cosine of the phase angle between the voltage and the current. And that cosine of the phase angle between voltage and current is called as power factor. We have a power factor. Now that is the expression for average power dissipation in AC circuit. Now we will study the different cases. First, case one. If the circuit is purely resistive, that means it contains only resistance, no inductance and no capacitance. If it is resistive, then the circuit is called resistive circuit. In the case of a resistive circuit, we have studied voltage and current are in phase. Then what is the phase angle? The phase angle phi is 0. Therefore, what about cos phi? Cos phi is equal to 1. So therefore, then what is the power dissipation? Is equal to Vrms into Irms. Now this is the maximum amount of power dissipated in the case of a resistive circuit. Case 2. If you have a pure capacitor or a pure inductor, either it has a capacitor circuit or it has a pure inductive circuit. In both the cases also we have studied, in the case of an inductor, current lagging behind the voltage or voltage leads, voltage mundirtane, current hindirtane, how much angles it is, pi by 2 we have studied. In the case of capacitor, current mundirta, voltage hindirta, current leads the voltage by pi by 2, whatever it may be. Therefore, we have a phase angle in the case of a pure capacitive or inductive circuit. Therefore, obviously, this phi is equal to pi by 2. Therefore, what is cos pi by 2? Cos pi by 2 becomes 0. Therefore, cos pi by 2 becomes 0. Then, what is the average power dissipation in the case of a pure inductive or a pure capacitive circuit? The power dissipation is 0. So, even though the current is flowing, the power dissipated in this circuit is 0, and hence that current is called wattless current. The current which produces a 0 power dissipation in an LCR in a circuit, in a pure inductive or a capacitive circuit, is called as wattless. It is not going to consume any power. Current is called as wattless current. That is the second case. Now third case, let me study the third case here. Case 3. In the case of an LCR circuit, what is the power dissipation? Just we have derived. In the case of an LCR circuit, it contains all the three, L, C and R, which are in series combination. We have derived that one. The power dissipation is equal to Vrms into Irms into cos phi, where phi is the phase angle. It is given by tan inverse of, we know that tan inverse of, it is Xc minus XL divided by R. Phi is given by tan inverse of Xc minus XL divided by R. This is by using impedance diagram. Okay. Now that is case 3. Okay. Now case 4. Now fourth case. At resonance, what about the power dissipation? In the case of a series LCR circuit, at resonance we have studied Xc should be is equal to XL. That is, capacitive reactance is equal to inductive reactance. Then what about the phase angle here? Phi is equal to tan inverse of 0 by R. R it is, phi is equal to 0. Cos phi is equal to 0. Phi is equal to 0, then what is cos phi? Therefore, the power factor is 1. Cos phi is 1. Then what is the average power dissipated? The average power dissipated is Vrms into Irms. Therefore, in the case of resonance phenomena, at resonance in an LCR circuit, the maximum power is dissipated. And that maximum power dissipation is given by bar P is equal to Vrms into Irms. Maximum power dissipates. Even though it contains L and C, the power is dissipated only through the resistor. If you have an RC circuit, there also power is dissipated only through the resistor. If you have RL circuit, the power is dissipated only at resistor part. You should remember this one. Now that is regarding the power in an AC circuit. The important is this one, cos phi. cosine of the phase angle between the voltage and the current is called power factor. Now we will work out on problem. A resistor of 200 ohm and a capacitor of 15 microfarad are connected in series in a 220 volt 50 hertz AC source. Calculate the current through the circuit. Calculate the voltage RMS across the resistor and the capacitor. Is the algebraic sum of the voltages more than the source voltage? If yes, resolve a parallax. Now we will write a simple circuit here. Now we have an AC source which is applied to a series resistor and a capacitor circuit. This is a simple circuit. Okay. Now this is the applied voltage. Now this is the voltage across the resistor and this is the voltage across the capacitor. Okay. If that is the case. Now given now resistor value is given. Now R is equal to, it is 200 ohm. Capacitor value is given, C is equal to 15 microfarad, that is equal to 15 into 10 raised to minus 6 farad. Now VRMS, RMS value of the voltage, source voltage, that is 220 volts, that is given, and the frequency of AC is given, it is 50 hertz. Now what we have to work out? First we have to work out capacitive reactance, then we have to work out the total impedance, then we have to work out RMS value of current in the circuit and the voltage across the resistor is VR and voltage across the capacitor, that is VC, that we have to work out. Okay. Now we know that the capacitive reactance is given by 1 upon 2 pi mu C, that is equal to 1 upon 2 into 3.14 into nu, frequency 50 hertz, capacitance is 15 into 10 raised to minus 6. Now if you simplify this one with a calculator, 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 15, that is equal to, I am getting 1 upon 4710 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Now further simplification leads to 1 divided by 4710 is equal to 0.30212 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Now here decimal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, therefore XC is equal to 212 ohms. This is the capacitive reactance. Now impedance, Z is equal to, it is square root of R square plus X square. Okay. We know that R square, square root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Here XL is 0. Therefore, it is XC square. So, 200 square plus 212 square. 200 square is 40,000 plus 212 into 212 is equal to 44,944. So, if we further simplify that one, therefore Z is equal to square root of 84,944. Square root of 84,944. Simplify that one, 291.5 ohms. 291.5 ohms we are getting. Now first we have to calculate what is the RMS value of the current in the circuit. IRMS is equal to VRMS divided by Z. Now VRMS, it is 220 divided by 291.5. Therefore, RMS value of current is equal to 220 divided by 291.5 is equal to 0.755 amps. Now, the voltage across the resistor VR is equal to IRMS into R is 0.755 into R is 200. Therefore, that is equal to 0.755 into 200 is equal to 151 volts. Similarly, voltage across the capacitor, it is RMS value of the current multiplied by capacitive reactance, that is 0.755 current multiplied by impedance 212, that is equal to 0.755 into 212, that is equal to 160 volts. Okay, so next one is very important one. What is the algebraic sum? Now, algebraic sum is equal to VR plus VC. VR is 151, VC is 160. 311 volts we are getting. We are applying only 220 volts here. Across the resistor, I am getting 151 volts. Across the capacitor, I am getting 160 volts. The total voltage is 220, but here it is 151, it is 160. If you add algebraically, since they are in series, if you add algebraically, we are getting 311 volts, which is the parallax. That is the parallax. Now, supply is 220, but the sum is 311. 11 per 5. So that means here we should not add algebraically. We have to add vectorially, because this voltage VC, it has a phase dependence with respect to the current. The voltage across the capacitor has a phase dependence with respect to the current. Therefore, the total voltage should be the vector sum of the voltage across the resistor and the voltage across the capacitor. Therefore, vector sum we have to take. Vector sum V is equal to square root of VR square plus VC square. That is equal to square root of, what is VR? We are getting 151. Square plus 160 square, that is equal to 151 into 151. I am getting square root of 22801 plus 150 25600. If you add them, we will get under square root 48401. The square root of 484 is 22. Therefore, it is 220 we are getting, is equal to 220 volts. What we are supplying? 220. And what we are getting? It is the 220. Therefore, in the case of an AC source, in the case of series combination, the voltage across each component has to be added vectorially to get the total voltage. Next problem, a sinusoidal voltage of peak value 283 volts and frequency 50 hertz is applied to a series LCR circuit in which R is equal to 3 ohm, L is equal to 25.48 millihenry and C is equal to 796 microfarad. Find impedance of the circuit, the phase difference between the voltage source voltage across the source and the current, and the power dissipated in the circuit, also the power factor. Now we have given a series LCR circuit. In that, the value of the peak voltage, that Vm, the maximum value of the voltage, amplitude of the voltage is given, that is 283 volts. Frequency is given, nu is equal to 50 hertz. Here RMS value is not given, they have given the peak voltage, remember that one. Frequency is 50 hertz and resistance R is equal to, it is 3 ohm, and inductance L is equal to 25.48 millihenry, or 25.48 into 10 to the power of minus 3 henry, and capacitance C is equal to 796 microfarad, that is 796 into 10 to the power of minus 6 farads. Now these are the given things. First we have to calculate impedance from that one, phase difference phi, then the power dissipated. In order to find the power dissipated, we have to calculate it, calculate IRMS and VRMS, then power and power factor. Those things we have to work out. Very simple problem. First we have to find out impedance. Now the inductive reactance XL is equal to 2 pi nu L, that is equal to 2 into 3.14 into frequency is 50 into L, it is 25.48 into 10 to the power of minus 3. XL is equal to, now work out that one, 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 25.48. I am getting 8,007.2 into 10 raised to minus 3. Our XL is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 becomes, it is 8 ohm. The inductive reactance is 8 ohm. Similarly, work out the capacitive reactance XC. XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi nu C, that is 1 upon 2 into 3.14 into 50 into capacitance 796 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Therefore, XC is equal to, if I multiply the numerator, 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 796 is equal to 249944 into 10 to the power of minus 6, that is 1 divided by 249944 is equal to 0.500004 into 10 to the power of minus 6, numerator tondra, it becomes plus 6. Therefore, if we work out that one, simplify, I am getting 4 ohms. The capacitive reactance is 4 ohms. Since it is an LCR circuit, first one, impedance. Now Z is equal to square root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square, general formula. Okay. Now it is equal to square root of R square, it is 3 square, plus XC, it is 4, XL, it is 8 whole square, that is equal to 3 square plus 4 square. Therefore, Z is equal to 5 ohms. 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16 plus 25. Therefore, square root of 25 is 5 ohms. Note the phase difference. that we have to work. Now phase difference is given, phi is equal to tan inverse of xc minus xl divided by r. This is the general formula. Okay, now we have obtained this equation assuming that xc greater than xl. Okay, but here xl is greater than xc, that should remember. That is equal to tan inverse of 4 minus 8 divided by 3, tan inverse of 4 by 3 minus 4 by 3, tan inverse of minus 4 by 3. Therefore, I am getting minus 53.1 degree, minus 53.1 degree. We are getting the negative sign, phase angle. What is that meaning? Here, since XL is greater than XC, the circuit behaves as inductive. The circuit behaves as inductive. But while deriving this formula, that circuit has behaved as a capacitive circuit. Therefore, there the current leads the voltage. But here, voltage leads the current. Voltage leads the current here. Since we are getting a negative sign for the phase, voltage is leading the current. How much it is leading, that we will calculate later on. Now power dissipated. In order to calculate the power dissipation, we have to calculate RMS value of the current and RMS value of the voltage, or simply either calculate RMS value of the current. IRMS is equal to V RMS divided by Z impedance. Okay. Now V RMS is not given, it is Vm is given. Therefore, it is Vm by Z into root 2. Vm by root 2 is V RMS. Now Vm is 283 divided by Z. We have got 5 into what is root 2? 1.41. If I simplify that one, 283 divided by 5 divided by 1.41, I am getting 40 amps. RMS value of the current is 40 amps. Now, the power dissipation we have to work out. I will do here. Now, power dissipated is equal to IRMS square into R, power dissipation. So this is equal to IRMS, just we have calculated, it is 40 square into 3, 1600 into 3. Therefore, power dissipation is 4800 watts. Lastly, power factor. Cos phi, that is cos 53.1 degree, if you work out, I will get 0.6. 0.6 is the power factor in the circuit. Like this. Next problem. Now, this problem is related to the previous one. It is an extension of the previous problem. A sinusoidal voltage of peak value 283 is applied to a series LCR circuit in which R is 3 ohm, L is 25.48 millihenry, and C is 796 microfarad. Suppose frequency is varied. Frequency is varying. What is the frequency of the source at which resonance occurs? Calculate the impedance, current, and power dissipated at the resonance condition. This we have to work out. Now, given peak value of the voltage, that is Vm is given, that is 283 volts. R is given, R is 3 ohm. L is given, 25.48 millihenry. Capacitance C is given, 796 microfarad. Okay, what you have to calculate? We have to calculate the resonance frequency nu naught. At the resonance frequency, we have to calculate what is the impedance, the current, IRMS and the power at resonance. We know that a series LCR circuit is at resonance whenever the inductive reactance should be equal to the capacitive reactance. By that one, the resonance frequency is given by 1 upon 2 pi root LC that we have worked out in the previous classes. So nu naught is the resonance frequency, that is 1 upon 2 pi into root of LC. Now substitute the values and simplify. Under square root, L is 25.48 into 10 raised to minus 3 millihenry into capacitance 796 into 10 to the power of minus 6. It is also under square root. So therefore, nu naught is equal to 1 upon 6.28 under square root 25.48 into 796, that is equal to 20.20282.08 into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to minus 3, minus 6, it is 10 raised to minus 9. Therefore, nu naught is equal to, now the further simplification gives the frequency is 35.4 hertz. Now at this frequency we are getting resonance. Okay, at resonance XL is equal to XC, therefore what is the impedance? Impedance Z is equal to square root of R square plus XC minus XL whole square. Now this term get cancels, therefore Z is equal to R, that is equal to 3 ohm. Therefore impedance at resonance is 3 ohms. Now we have to calculate RMS value of the current is equal to VRMS divided by R, not Z, because we are calculating at resonance. So VRMS is Vm by root 2 multiplied by the resistance R. Now Vm is 283 divided by R value 3 into root 2. Root 2 is 1.41. Therefore 283 divided by 3 divided by 1.41, that is equal to 66.9. Now this is the RMS value of the current. And power dissipation. Now at resonance, the power dissipation is equal to IRMS square into R. Now IRMS square 66.9 whole square into 3. That is 66.9 into 66.9 into 3. 13,426.83 watts. Therefore, power dissipation is 13.43 kilowatts. Now, compare this problem with the previous one. In the previous, the power dissipation is 4,800 watt only. Now, here is 13,000 watts of power is dissipating. Therefore, at resonance, the current is maximum and power dissipation is also maximum. So, in the previous, the RMS value of the current we have got 40 amps. Now, here at resonance, we are getting 66.9 amps of current.